Hey guys, Tyro here, bringing you a 1v1 today. We are on Crossing in the Woods. This match is between Mirageflare, it's spawning here in the south, playing as the US forces. And his loadout is Infantry Company, Armor Company, and Airborne Company. Spawning in the north, playing for the Austere is Hearts of Iron Zarklout. And his loadout is elite troops, mechanized assault, and close air support. So pretty much what we saw last patch. We'll see how he gets on.
Rifle squad ready
Of
for action.
course, close air support did receive a few nerfs. Redistribute resources, giving less munitions and anti-infantry and anti-tank strafe taking longer between using the ability and the plane actually arriving. Also see a lot of Talonmine munition cost reduction bulletins there from Zarklout. Also had a look at Zarklout's player card. He's pretty much top 50 with every faction. Of course Mirageflare also a very experienced player, very highly ranked. Cast him a couple of times before. First engagement here, Pioneers versus Rear Echelons. Rear Echelons vault the fence to get out of the line of fire of that MG42. MG42 repositions. Definitely looks like Zarklout wants to lock down this left-hand fuel point. Rifles here crossing the river. Take one model loss on approach. Oh, and another one right there. That's a terrible engagement there from Mirageflare. A bit of bad luck, even at close range. Losing two models, you're not going to win against the Grenadiers. And that's the thing with Crossing in the Woods, though they did remove the speed penalty moving through water. There is still all this negative cover here. Very dangerous to approach across. Looks like we're going to see some rifles engaging the Grenadiers. Rifles rushing for this truck's heavy cover. Should be able to stall here for a while, but here comes MG42 rotating to support, and that should swing the engagement in Zarklout's favour. But he did set it up right on the edge of those rifles. Luckily it's suppressed on that first burst. I was going to say he could have walked up a bit further. Made sure that it found its mark. Early teller going down from Zarklout right in the center. And we are going to see the lieutenant, so we may see an M20, and that mine could pay dividends. Actually, may have just been spotted there by those rifles. Oh, and it gets swept straight away. Oh, it looks like he didn't even finish planting it. He just gave up. Luckily, he avoided that loss of munitions there. And nicely done there by Mirageflare. Just bring in the sweepers just in case. Don't want to lose your M20 straight away. In fact, Mirageflare is not going for an M20. He's actually going for a 50 cal. And we see a second machine gun coming out here now from Zarklout, so... Some people do call this map camping in the woods, and if you do set up two MG42s, it can be very hard for the allies to try and outmaneuver those on this map. Lieutenant approaching those two Grenadiers, forcing them back. MG42 retreats that squad there. Rifle sitting here waiting for the lieutenant to come on the flank. Is successful. And those rifles should come out of suppression shortly. This one's repositioning, trying to stay safe from all these flanking troops coming from Mirageflare. Still hasn't kept this right-hand VP though. He needs to get that going. His allies, you need to get that early game victory point advantage. especially on a map like Crossing in the Woods, where when it comes to the late game, it can really drag out for a long period of time, with the center VP constantly getting capped and decapped. You want to get that early game victory point advantage if you possibly can. The echelons look like they're going to do some back capping there. All the action centered on the left. 50 cal suppresses those pioneers. Now on super low health, they're dropping models like crazy, and that squad goes down. Very risky to keep it around there, even though it's four men who were super low on health, and it quickly got diced down by the lieutenant there. So a bit of 50 cal support. 50 cal suppresses that green squad. Lieutenant continues to sit in this garrison, causing issues for this MG42. 50 cal suppresses that rifle squad now too. So this is going really well for Mirage Flyer. He's managed to cut off Zarklout from his fuel. Zarklout is now fielding a 222. And in comes some Pathfinders actually now for Mirage Flyer. So we're seeing no vehicles so far from Mirage Flyer, which is a bit of a surprise with US forces. You usually see something rolling out of them pretty early.
Air resupply is now available.
Maybe thinking about going for the AA half track. Two, trying to deal with the lieutenant, force it to retreat at the very least. 222 doesn't want to sit in the 50 cal fire. That 50 cal can actually do decent damage to light vehicles. Looks like it's going to return to base for some repairs, and because Zarko lost that flame of pyro squad, he actually has to rebuild his pioneers. It's going to delay the repairs on the 222. This stage, I think Zarklow may be thinking of going for a pack next. It's generally what you would be doing about now, expecting some kind of light vehicle from the US forces. And we do see a light vehicle. Oh no, okay, that's just the ambulance. Okay. Fifty cal suppresses those pathfinders. They should be able to crawl to safety though. 50 cal repositions there. MG42 now suppressed. In comes 222, has completed repairs. But there is a captain here with bazookas, so that's where all of Mirage Flyer's fuel has gone. It's both lieutenant and captain. Giving them the full spectrum of team weapons available. And I actually heard about this build from Dusty, not going for an early light vehicle and just battling out with team weapons and infantry. So we'll see if that's what Mirage Flyer is planning to do. Ooh, Captain always goes down there, drops the bazooka, and looks like Zarklow's going to pick that bad boy up. I'm not sure what that was. I heard a unit get lost. Ready to copy. That was the captain. The captain did go down. Must have been a super long range snipe there.
Our supply line just got cut off.
So that's a bit of a setback from Mirage Flyer, losing a bazooka to his Axis counterpart. Watch your sound. And really, because Mirage Flyer decided to go with no vehicle, there's really nothing that's punishing Zarklow right now for not having a pack. And this is get ready for sometimes the game you play. Pathfinder's ready for action. Oh, this 50 cal running out to the front lines with one man. That's a brave, brave squad. Looks like Mirage Flyer's actually going for Stuart. Very late Stuart. Very, very late, Stuart. Not sure about that. See, Zarklout has filled some Panzer Grenadiers. Doesn't have enough munitions for a Shrek though. He hasn't had very good map control so far. Quite far behind in terms of victory points as well. About 100 VPs behind already. 50 cal set up here in the corner. Unless he plans to send his ambulance up there, I'm sure that's a good idea. You risk losing that 50 cal. Rifles coming out here through the flank. Maybe trying to find a angle to get an AT grenade off on that 222, and then he could follow that up with his Stuart. Here he comes. He's doing a bit of a pincer maneuver. Shell shock activated. 222 is stunned. Doesn't want to cross this, but I'm not sure why. He's got the sweepers there. Could definitely cross that. Doesn't even matter. Stuart, laser accuracy, knocks out the 222 there. And actually destroys the wreck there, denying the heavy cover to his opponent. Here come the Panzer Grenadiers. They're tearing into these rifles. There's nothing to stop this Stuart here. The only thing that's keeping him at bay is the risk of a Panzerfaust, but actually Zarklout doesn't have enough munitions for that even.
We're losing a capture point.
What did he spend his 60 munitions on just before? Oh, he's put down some S mines over here. Don't see any tellers. Usually you'd expect a teller. I don't see any in the AOE of that. That Pioneer squad. Looks like Mirage Flyer may be thinking bar finders. Getting bars on Pathfinders is quite a popular strategy. They added DPS from the bar combined with the sniping ability of the Pathfinders. Makes them a pretty effective anti-infantry unit. Panzer Grenadiers closing close range, and they're getting diced up by the Lieutenant, supported by those rifles.
75mm gun ready for action.
Very passive with his Stuart so far, his Mirage Flap. Doesn't want to run into any tellers, and I suppose that's the effect you can have when you've got so many teller bulletins. Your opponent's like, oh damn, I don't want to do any risky moves with my vehicles. This is almost guaranteed to be some teller mine somewhere. We do see Zarklout has selected close air support. As you can see, redistribute resources now going 125 and set up. I believe it was 150 before, so slight nerf there. Too close air support. Stuart trying to engage against the Grenadiers at long range. This Green squad does have that stolen bazooka though. Bazooka's very, very inaccurate at long range. This is also quite a popular spot for a mine. Marashfly had to rebuild this re-echelon squad to do some more sweeping. He's actually done a bit of miss micro there. Briefly jumped out of the capping circle. We see a beacon down here. All Mirage Flyer allows the forward reinforcement of Pathfinders and Paratroopers, I believe. It's just Paratroopers. Gun ready. That is a pack out to now from Mirage Flyer. Panzer Grenadiers force away those rear echelons, but at least they managed to decap that fuel. So Zarklout's really hurting for fuel so far. Pretty much standard close air support so far.
What the hell am I meant to do with these recruits? Green as green can be.
He hasn't ticked any further up. He's got the double pack. So we'll see if close air support maintains its efficacy against US forces. It was always quite troublesome against US forces. Very tough strategy to beat. Here come the packs, trying to find a line on the Stuart. Stuart slightly backing up. Sets up just in range, misses the first shot. Stuart.
There's a
late to react. Second shot misses as well. It's quite a tough spot to shoot from, I guess. Stuart backs to safety there. Action going on in the center. Grenadier's probably going to try rifle grenade the pack out, sir. Oh, and they clear it in one rifle grenade. Wow, that was just brutal. Huge amount of munitions there banked up by Mirage Fire. I'm really surprised that he hasn't gone for bars. He hasn't got any paratroopers, and his infantry is losing out to these Grenadiers. Could they do us a few bars? I know people when playing Airborne often want to try save up almost all their munitions for P-47s, but not sure if that's the right decision in this case. P-47s are not always that accurate, and Mirage Fire could definitely be doing better if he actually... Whoa, look at that Stuart shot! Wipes three-man green squad with the bazooka. Packout has been recruited. I imagine that was by that re-echelon squad that's now retreating. Barraging away at that pack 40 there. No grenades either. Text by Mirage Flash, so he's got no defences against this MG42. Stuart looks like it wants to kind of move into position, but here comes the lieutenant from the side. Gets chased away by those LMG Grens. So no luck through the center for Mirage Fly. He's now going to move his Stuart to the sides. Looks like an S-mine field going down here. It's one way to use your munitions. Very late reaction here from Zarklout. He should be able to run over that minefield with his Stuart if he chooses to do so. Looks like he's actually not going to run that risk of there being a Talamine there as well. Maybe he sends his sweepers over there shortly. Zarklout's now reached 10 command points. Could go for anti-tank strafe if he finds an opportunity. Still hasn't ticked any further. Just solely relying on his core of infantry so far. Back out, sir. Largely off target, firing upon those Panzergrenadiers. Do see the Major now from Mirage Flat. And it looks like he's going for a Jackson. Surprising choice. Not really much for Jackson to do at the moment. I suppose it does give him some peace of mind. It's not like it's completely obvious so far that Zarklout is using close air support, I suppose. Because he's used munitions transfer a few times, but he hasn't actually spent the munitions, so he's at a close to natural level of munitions expenditure. Here comes a Stuart, double packs set up. Misses that shot, penetrates on that shot. That's lucky for Mirage Fly there, getting away with the Stuart. Oh, nasty bundle grenade, wipes the squad there. In come the LMG Greens from the side. Packs following closely behind. Pack out, so though it forces a retreat. MG42 also advancing. Jackson's on the field, just roaring around, not up to much. Zarklout could now tick up, I suppose. Middle phase 2, 45 fuel. And if he ticked up there, he could be pretty close to a Stuart by the time tick and construction completes. Oh, wow. Nasty Pack Howitzer shot there. Oh, and he destroys the gun. The MG42 gun got destroyed there. Must have been on low health. I suppose at the very least it doesn't fall into the Allies' hands, but gun destroyed there. You got to see that change in effect. Team weapons not dying while the crew was still on them, but dying as soon as the crew dies if they are no health. Panzer unit is quickly shredding these rear echelons here on the right. Lieutenant trying to flank the MG42. Incendiary rounds now used by Zarklau. That should do heaps of damage to this lieutenant, but the gunner got sniped there briefly. Well, lieutenant's quickly going down. Looks like the steward just went down there to the packs. Where are those packs? They're quickly backing away. Job done. So a series of very, very poor engagements there for Mirage Flyer. Spread across all fronts. I believe he lost his rear echelons, lost his steward, lost his lieutenant. That could be the swing in momentum that Zarklau needs to get back in this game. Spread too thin across all the fronts. Now bringing in some paratroopers. I imagine he's going to upgrade them with some M1919s. Should increase his chances against the LMG Grenadiers. This is quite a long range engagement map, so Thompson's probably not the best idea. 50 cal sets up. Quickly suppresses that Grenadier squad pack out to here in support. Whoa, that's a nice shot. And mass retreat there from Zarklau. Jackson briefly joins in on the fun. He took it off Proto's vehicles just to see if he could get a lucky shot off there. It was unsuccessful though. Masses and masses of infantry now from Zarklau, so he has abandoned teching for the moment. Does have quite a bit of fuel in the back. Surely by now Mirage Flyer anticipates that he is facing close air support. Back out to get a... Whoa, that second shot was a good one. Those two shots came off in quite quick succession. I haven't really played around with it much myself, but I believe he did an auto fire shot and then quickly followed up by a barrage, and the barrage shot came a bit quicker than two auto fire shots would usually arrive, but I could be incorrect. Oh, there's a nasty green blob there. Paratroopers have to reposition to a slightly more safe position. 50 cal. They're just on the edge of its arc of fire. It's trying to reposition, turn to face. First volley doesn't suppress. Second volley doesn't suppress. Pack out's a shot way off target. In comes anti-infantry strafe. And that's going to force a mass retreat there from Mirage Flat. Oh, pack out so connects. Paratroopers need to get out of here though. And yes, that is what Mirage Flyer does. If you do the auto fire shot and then quickly followed by a barrage, looks like you can get two shots off in very quick succession. So that's a nice little trick there from Mirage Flyer. Have to keep that in mind for my own games.
We're losing a capture point.
So if we look at the map, we can see that Zarklau's close air support is kicking in. Series of three terrible engagements for Mirage Flyer really just set him back. Lost his steward, lost his lieutenant, lost his rear echelons, and now we can see the benefits being reaped by Zarklau. He's got triple cap running. It's quickly going to even up the victory points if this continues. Packouts are firing from reasonably long range. LMG Greens dispensed. We do see bars now, finally, from Mirage Flyer. He's got them on his Pathfinders as well. Oh, that was his Major that went down there to this LMG Green fire. Paratroopers closing to close range on the Grenadiers. In comes another anti-infantry strafe. That's going to be a mass retreat once more. Looks like his Pathfinders may be able to stick it out if they come out of suppression. Actually, that's a fresh... Oh, that's a Scott, in fact. I can see that's a fresh Stuart, but no, here comes a Scott. So it looks like Marshall is going to use his... Oh, that rifle squad needs to get out of there. Oh, counts of motor. Double 75mm shells there. Nice job in that LMG Green squad. And I believe that was a Vet 3 squad, so it's a bit of a setback there for Zarklau. Should allow Mirage for a bit more room to breathe. Start pushing out again. Krauts are taking one of our points. 50 cal set up here against this Green squad. Oh wow, look at that Scott shot! Wipes that Green, and just like that, Mirage Flyer's back in the game. Stuka dive bomb. Oh, clears the pack out, so it doesn't destroy the gun though, so it can be recruited without too many issues. Still Mirage Flyer a bit. Despite those two wipes, we still see army size pretty similar for both players here. Another transfer activated by Zarklout. I think Mirage should probably consider moving his Jackson down here into base and decrewing it, reducing the population tax on his manpower. Pathfinders need to get out of the LMG Greens. Oh no, Scott's in a bad position, could get laser beamed down by these packs. Playing a risky game, those two packs, that's all it will take to destroy that Scott. Riflemen with double bars quickly shredding those Panzergrenadiers, forcing a retreat. 50 cal here set up, halting those Grenadiers' advance. Oh, that Scott, man, this thing is all money. Wreaking havoc on Zarklau's troops. That Packhauser got stolen, in fact, by Zarklau. That's a nice feather in his cap. Looks like we're going to see a Sherman now from Mirage Flight. Still no armor or tech from Zarklau. Does have quite a bit of fuel banked. Two packs set up here, trying to find a line on that Scott. It's a risky game playing your Scott against two packs. As I said, two shots and the Scott will go down. All it requires is one little mistake, and Scott is history. Tank support is here. Sherman ready. Another anti-infantry strafe coming in. That's going to force Mirage Flyer back once more. Looks like he just dodged it with his rifle squad, though. Didn't have to retreat there. LMG Paras. Very low health, but they should still be able to win at long range against those Pioneers. Actually, here comes the Panzergrenadiers, they could swing the engagement. Packouts are now turned against the US forces of Mirage Flight. Oh, that MG42 is lucky to escape with its life. Paratroopers, oh, they're dancing with death there. Looks like they're just going to get away from all of these... LMG Grenadiers, so many. So four LMG Grenadiers and one squad of Panzergrenadiers. Scott here is in a risky position. It's going to take a pack shot. Where's the second pack though? Second pack was back in base, healing and reinforcing. That's going to allow Scott to retreat. Sherman is now the focus of those packs. Oh, that's a nice hit there. And that's going to be a mass retreat from Zarklau. All those troops on quite low health would quickly lose a lot of squad members if he decided to continue engaging. Once again, rear echelon's doing some low capping here on the right. Good to use a low combat value unit like that to do some capping. Barfinder's quickly shredding that pack howitzer. Here comes the 50 cap, or the MG42 actually though, and Barfinder's decided to retreat. Still, Zarklout has managed to get both the fuels under his control, and he's got a lot of fuel in the bank here. Looks like Mirage Flyer did finally decide to decruise Jackson back here in the base. Sherman HE rounds tearing into these Panzer Grenadiers. Scott joining in on the fun. Actually sets off a Talamine there. That was a lucky... Oh, but down goes the Scott. That's what I was saying. It's very, very tough for the Scott against two packs. Sherman's trying to follow up. He knows that this is quite a popular spot for a Talamine though as well. Doesn't want to risk losing his Sherman. Takes... Whoa! What was that? Anti-tank strafe as well is... Massive pack fire there. Sherman lucky to escape with its life. Probably use this vehicle crew to come and speed up the repairs. Mine's getting cleared out there by those rear echelons. 50 cal, not having much success trying to suppress all these squads. In comes another anti-infantry strafe. Oh, it pins everything here now, and that's actually 250 cals from Mirage Fly. Looks like they're going to stick out the suppression. I hear that the 50 cal actually does decent damage as well. Looks like he's going to reposition the second 50 cal. He's not having much success in actually pinning that squad. Oh, lucky back out to shot there. Retreat. Yeah, those Grenadiers are not having much fun under that 50 cal fire. Mirage Fire is really hurting now. Losing that Scott to those double packs, causing him a few issues. Looks like Zarklout's going to invest into more indirect fire. Pack outs and now Mortar coming out. Realizing that the Mirage Fly is going quite heavy into infantry and team weapons with the double 50 cals, deciding to get some indirect fire to deal with it that way. Pretty good idea, honestly. We do now see Shrix on this Panzer Grenadier squad. Decides he needs a little bit of extra anti-tank against... It's this Sherman here. Sherman does still have to be careful against double Grenadiers. Two Fausts will cause the engine damage. So he's not completely in the clear here. Looks like the packs are repositioning now to the right. Second Sherman now from Mirage Fly. May try and catch some of these squads on the rotation. Is going to find this Panzer Grenadier squad. Oh, but it's behind the shot blocker. Kind of tree there. Misses that shot anyway. Pack's now in a better position to fire upon this Sherman. Big push coming across here from Mirage Flyer. In comes anti-infantry strafe though. Barfinders though get behind that MG. Oh, and it goes down. Sherman's in a lot of trouble. Here comes anti-tank strafe. Well off target. Mirage Flyer exits to the left. Should be successful in escaping. Another Sherman gets a cheeky pot shot off before also retreating. So this is a decent spot from Mirage Flyer. He managed to switch sides, moved most of Zarklout's forces over here, kind of diverting all their attention with those Shermans while pushing with all his infantry on the left, and that seems to be quite an effective strategy. And now he's put down a beacon here, allowing his paratroopers to reinforce on the front lines. That's also Also very nice from Rajvat. Perhaps he needs some more indirect fire though, once more. Oh, that's a nasty mortar shell, that rifle squad. Oh, almost got wiped out by that follow-up pack after shot. Here come the Barfinders though. Tearing into these team weapons. Mass retreat there from Zarkar quickly clears that pack. And decides to do some capping instead of continuing the chase. Probably the safer option. Paratroopers have finished reinforcing, so they're gonna continue their advance. There's a bit of healing going on here in the back. Sharon returns to the front lines, realizing that there's only one pack at the moment. It's a bit safer to do some more risky maneuvers with his Sherman. I really don't like the sound of the 30 cal now on the paratroopers. Ever since about two patches ago, they changed the sound, and it just sounds really weird. H.E. Sherman blasting away at these grenadiers. Only one of these packs has target weak point available. Oh, but there's a Panzer Shriek on that squad, and that almost wipes out the Sherman. And there you can see the effects of the delay on the anti-tank strafe. Very, very slow compared to what it was before, making it a lot easier to dodge those anti-tank strafe strafes. What the hell am I going to do with these enemies? Green as green can be. Fresh mag. Well, grab your shit and follow me. Take stock. We see a huge infantry force from Zarkar, also a lot of fuel still in the bank.
We're bleeding points like a stone.
You know, he
pig.
Could probably tick up and get it, some armor out, but I'm still surprised he hasn't done so. Instead we're gonna see all infantry play here. And the infantry strafe coming in here in the center, pinning that squad, suppressing this one. I think Panzer Grenadiers will win that now that that squad's pinned. Oh no, I missed!
A medium tank was just lost.
Double packs there, knocking out the Sherman. Do we still have one Sherman? Did that other Sherman get destroyed somehow? Oh no, it's over the in the back here. Rajvat actually using that vehicle crew from the Jackson to do some capping there on the right. Stuka dive bomb dodged there by the 50 cal. Rajvat still has quite a lot of munitions in the bank. I suppose that's one reason why Zarkar may be thinking otherwise about going for armor. 50 cal suppresses one squad. There's quite a lot of bars here as well. Maybe I should go head to head with these LMG grenadiers. It does, and forces a mass retreat. We look at victory points, we see Marashfly in a dire situation. Down only 40 victory points.
Orders incoming.
Maybe should consider ticking grenades. It could swing things in his favor. Just have plenty of munitions in the bank. Need something to burn it all on. May knock out this MG on retreat here. No. Decides against continuing the chase there. Vehicle crew's now in a bit of trouble under LMG Greenfire. I don't even know how much vehicle crews cost to reinforce. Sherman's operating on the flanks once more, going to chase away these LMG Greens. What was that? Oh, that must have been those... Was it paratroopers up here? Whatever that squad was up here, I believe it went down. And also the pack ups got cleared. Oh, rifle grenade wipes the 50 cal. Oh, just raining down rifle grenades here. 50 cal stand a little chance against masses and masses of rifle grenades. Second Sherman now from Mirage Flasso. He's going to try to do it with vehicles. The squad does have the Shrek, remember, making them extra lethal. No lucky shots there from the Sherman. Just a minor bit of bleed inflicted. Decides to halt right here with his Pathfinders, realizing it's probably a MG covering the center if he advances any further. Sherman comes in from the flank here. He's getting a bit desperate. Decides to abandon the caution that he was showing earlier with regards to the telemines. Manages to wipe the center victory point. Here comes the anti-infantry strafe. Oh, nicely Packhouse shot there. Packs open up on the Sherman. It's trying to turn around. It's going to take a Faust and down it goes. Two packs and it's just so good. Like, two packs are just so strong against tanks. Really, just really hard to deal with. I don't think he's even using target weak point there. Another feather in the cap of the pack. Such a good rate of fire. And such good penetration. Mirage Flyer really in a lot of trouble now, down to only 38 victory points. He's about to lose control of the center victory point as well. Squad looks like they're tempted to go along and get a triple cap running on the right. So we're seeing that close air support is still very viable. The slight nerf to the munitions transfer. Not completely invalidating it. Very hard to get the anti-tank strafe going, but the anti-infantry strafe still seems to be somewhat effective. And of course the heart of the strategy, upgrading all your troops with LMGs, masses of telemines, and two packs. Seems to be working quite well. Oh, that was a good shot there from the Sherman. Just trying to dodge these packs while inflicting as much damage as he can on his opponent. So Mirage Flyer's desperately trying to send something out to the right. He has managed to cap this victory point here. Here comes the Panzer Grenadiers. Oh, here comes the anti-tank strafe though. He's going to back right into the packs. And he's quickly taken out there, and that should be the end of the match. Well played by both players. Marshall had a really nice strong opening. Didn't use as much of his munitions, especially early, as he could have. I believe he's trying to save up for the P-47s, but Zarkloud never once built a vehicle this whole game, just playing solely with infantry. Well, actually, no, he built a 2-2-2, but that doesn't really count. If Mirage Flyer maybe had got bars slightly earlier for his troops, he might have been able to finish the job in the early game. Anyway guys, I'll wrap on that. If you'd like your game to be cast by me, details are in the video description below. Otherwise I'll catch you all for the next thrilling installment. Goodbye and good luck.